levanta un pueblo entero lleno de angustia, luchando por su digna patria, lograda con el coraje, desgarrando cada día con sus principios éticos. El vil imperio, su adversario político, que siempre ha combinado el engaño con la ignorancia para darse a conocer a toda voz. Pero el mundo conoce su verdadero rostro, porque cuando un pueblo enérgico y viril llora, la injusticia tiembla.
Change experience of what they have been doing in their own communities, in their own countries, because only with solidarity we can get the solution of this case. Yesterday we hear all the necessity the Cuban people had to fight terrorism, to send persons like our relatives to infiltrate those groups based on Miami. But now is the time to work. It's the time to work to push and to mobilize the public opinion, not only here in Canada, but also, and more important, in the United States. In Obama's hands is the solution of this case. Obama dignified is the compact word from this moment on. We are in a very important moment in the case, the Habeas Corpus. You already know about that, and I'm not going to repeat the same. But in Obama's hands is the possibility to free them, so we have to prepare the atmosphere for him to take that decision. And now, in the American government, they are involved in the re-election, in the elections, but it's very important for Obama get re-elected, because with Romney, we will never find any solution for the case. It will be worse for us, as relatives, for them, as prisoners. We can remember the era of Bush, where everything was very difficult for us. There were more violations of human rights than with the Obama administration, even though we can say that Trump, I think that, oh my goodness. Again, that's the only possibility we have to inform him about all these kinds of events we are taking part. I just talked to him just a few minutes ago. He was informed by Colombia, who sent him an email telling about the day yesterday, about all the interventions, all the statements and speakers yesterday here in this salon. So I didn't have to talk to explain him about this. But he's very aware that with actions like this one, with events like this one here that took place in Toronto, is the way to open the cell, is the way to change the situation of the actor that is suffering the most, because he was sentenced to 2 life prison terms, plus 15 years, and moreover, this situation of the denial of the visa and Adriana, and they still don't have the visa, at least the kind of visa that the other relatives have been doing during this year, in this impersonal way, some inhumane way, because those visits are not the ones that maybe some people can imagine, that we have some kind of physical contact or privacy, not that way. Very impersonal, in a place that is no good for having a relation with a person that is in prison. But at least I can do it. If it's worse for Adriana, he has been worse for all that, and they have been denied from this possibility. So I want to thank you again for inviting us to take part in this important event, just to ask you to continue working and assisting in this role that is the one that we are hoping. Because we have been doing everything possible in the judiciary system, we have been taking all the facts, but that's for us, that's not the solution. The solution is here, in solidarity, in all you can do, in all the pressure you can put in the public opinion of the United States to allow Mr. Obama to sign what Amnesty International said to him, to make use of his prerogative as president and sign the release of the Cuban Five in a kind of clemency or pardon or any other option. That's our hopes, that's what that is something that gives us strength to continue fighting, to know that we have a lot of persons accompanying us, doing something in favor of them, No, but I think, like Gloria said, that any action we are doing is small. Out of small things, we can make a big thing. So they continue doing that. We will do the same as families. The Cuban people will continue doing the same as people. And that's the way. I hope someday we can be all together here or in Havana celebrating the return of the Cuban flag to Cuba. And I hope I can see all of you in that moment. For Ramon and for the other four, they will never have enough time to shake the hands of all our friends that have been supporting of the Cuban flag, because they are committed to do it in the moment. Because it's important for you, for all of you to know that even though they cannot answer all letters, they cannot express in all messages all the gratitude, you are in their hearts, you are in their minds all the time, because you are the ones that have the possibility to open their doors. So thank you very much, and I will give the floor to Adriana to say a few words, and somebody will translate for her.
Elizabeth ha resumido el sentir de todos los familiares.
I don't have a lot more to say. Elizabeth summed up the feelings of all the families.
Siempre lo hacemos cuando viajamos. No solo representamos a nuestro esposo, sino a todos los demás.
We always do this when we travel. We don't represent just our own husbands, but we represent all the others.
Lo más importante que se ha dicho en este evento.
The most important things have already been said in this event.
Pero pienso que más allá, lo que nos queda es seguir actuando y seguir luchando.
But I think beyond that, what is left to us is to keep acting, to keep struggling.
Este es un escenario para organizar ideas y acciones.
This is a place to organize ideas and action.
Quisiéramos que no tuviéramos que celebrar ninguno otro para seguir trazando estrategias, pero sabemos que la realidad es mucho más dura. Y tenemos que seguir haciéndolo.
We wish we wouldn't have to keep having these kind of activities to lay out strategies, but we know that reality is much more difficult, and we will have to keep doing this.
Por eso solo quiero terminar diciéndoles adelante que tenemos que continuar. Muchas gracias.
Con sus principios éticos, el vil imperio, su adversario político, que siempre ha combinado el engaño con la ignorancia para darse a conocer.